Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Ark Survival Evolved Scorched Earth. I went ahead and took off the last 2 days because I was super stressed from school and I just needed a break. Like, making these videos and going to class and doing all kinds of schoolwork, it takes its toll on you. So this weekend I went to my girlfriend's and helped her build a computer. So that means she's finally going to be joining us in our Ark server. But that also means the last 2 or 3 days I wasn't able to play on this server. So I just logged in and we are super fortified now. I mean, I haven't seen everything yet, but it looks like we've got a whole bunch of turrets on the roof. We've got turrets on the inside. We've got some awesome, like, I don't know, stone wall pillar things over here, which I can't remember what those pillars do, but I'm pretty sure there's like a defensive reason to have these kind of pillars. And I'm pretty sure this is Falcon because he likes designing these beautiful little taming pins, which is awesome. But our base is really coming along. Of course, we're going to have to work on redesigning the inside a little bit and stuff like that. But last time I left, I walked around and put up flags all over the base, which now appear to have giant penises on them. Actually, quite a few, maybe 6 penises on that one. And in fact, even the single panels now have penises on them. So that's kind of a bummer. I don't think I can repaint them. So I was gonna put hearts on it, but nope, can't repaint that. So now I got some nice penis flags. That's wonderful, fantastic. I guess we gotta leave them. I don't know why we would change it. Looks pretty good. And we got a little garden over here. Looks like a plant species Y maybe blooming up right there. Is it? Plant species Y it is. And then another cool thing I want to show you, which I'll be going on a milk run here in a second, which I've never done before. We have a juvenile wyvern. We are back, guys. We are back. We are better than ever. We've got wyverns. We've got these parasitium guys. T-Rex. Is that 2 T-Rexes? I mean, look at this. Look at all these dinos we have. We are really pulling together. Of course, this looks like something to hatch an egg with, I'm gonna bet. Of course, I've done absolutely no work on the server. Basically, all of this was here when I joined, and my tribe mates have done the rest of the work. We've got a pretty solid tribe size now. I mean, what is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 people. I think a couple of them no longer play, but like, you look around here, you see these dinos. It's pretty awesome. And basically, we're gonna work up pretty quickly now, I think, to the point where we can do some crazy raids. And I don't know what kind of raids we'll get, because I'm not... Ooh, I think I just froze. I'm not sure what kind of raids we're going to get because I'm not really sure what kind of bases are here because I haven't been able to explore a whole lot. But I know that this is a pretty decent base, but it's not that good. Like when you look at it, the walls are weak, the inside's weak, and all it really has is a lot of turrets. But that could be easily avoided if someone like dropped a turtle on it or something to distract the turrets. They could come down here, blow inside. And you look at how like unsegmented it is in here. Everyone's sleeping in the same room. All of our items are in the same room. So it's kind of crappy that it's like that, but it's pretty insane when you think about all the work that we've done. And by we, I'm not including myself in that because I'm doing none of it. Whole bunch of metal, whole bunch of pearls, clay, all this stuff that sucks to collect. And there's my cooking pot. Oh, you already put one up. I got some cooking pots out because I wanted to make some paint because I wanted to get this like a nice little red and white paint theme, get some hearts on there, make it nice and friendly. But instead we got some silver penises, so it's about the same thing, I guess, when you think about it. So this is awesome. I'm really happy. Oh, we gotta check upstairs real quick. I have no idea. What was that? Oh, what's up, Bobby? I have no idea what's upstairs, if it's any different. Oh my goodness, we got a little, well, we got a start of something up here, a little argent. I'm not sure how you got up here. Whoa, I didn't know you could put that like in the floor. That's kind of cool. And what are these? Oh, a lot of air conditioners. Oh, so this has got to be like a breeding type room. And a turret on the inside, just in case anyone breaks in, we'll have this taken care of. So there's definitely some redesigning to do. Oh, there's a ceiling roof. I see. See, I haven't used one of those yet, so that must be like the first time I've seen it. Wow, that's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. I like it. That was the update that everyone got when this Scorched Earth expansion came out. They gave everyone else a roof hole in the roof, whatever you want to call it. Wind turbine. Dang, how's this guy get so many materials? That's pretty crazy. I mean, I guess, oh, these guys are making their noise. That means something's coming. What do you guys level up when you have, oh my.
Just grab a chainsaw and some fuel.
What's that?
So I'm ready to go when you are. Just grab a chainsaw and some fuel.
I'm ready to go. Let's do it. I don't know if you said I need a chainsaw, but that I do not have.
Get a chainsaw, we can kill it. Good experience for you.
Chainsaw. Chainsaw. Where's the chainsaw at?
Should be in this third one.
Oh, the third one. I checked the second one. Oh, got it. Looked at the wrong one. Don't know why I got a chainsaw, and I don't really know how to use it, so let's check this bad boy out. Oh, ho, 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 ho. Oh, ho, 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 ho. That's a weird thing. I don't know what he just said. But these guys are just freaking out, aren't they? They're so cute. Look at them. I didn't know you could give them hats. I'm going to take this one with me. Let's go, buddy. Put away the chainsaw. Oh, wait. 1 second. I'm encumbered. I got to drop some things off. Oopsies. I was like, why are we moving so slow? I thought it was the chainsaw, but I guess it's actually what we have holding. This is our cactus. Let's go ahead and just throw all that in there. A couple rocks. A little bit of that. A little bit of everything. Don't need that. Nice and organized. That's how I like to do things. Oh, don't need the cooking pot. Don't need the paint. We're good to go. Let's do this. Let's go get us some dragon milk. I think. Dragons lay milk? Is that what they do? I don't know. All right. Ready when you are. I have no idea where the dragons are, and I have no idea how to get dragon milk, so this is going to be an adventure. Mr. Bobby is going to teach me how it's done. Let's go, Bob. So, while we're flying, if you guys are watching this part right now, which you are, I have to start accepting that. I have to start accepting that people watch my stuff. I can't just assume no one watches anymore, which is what I do. But I'm actually looking at a server right now that's a roleplay server. So for those of you who don't know, it's like a server where you go on and you pick, like, I don't know, like a personality, like a type of person you want to be, and you have to be that person. And that sucks. So the person I picked was a guy who lives alone, doesn't have any tribe, doesn't have any friends, and he hires people to kill. He like hires hitmen, and he sells things that they steal. So he's like a really crazy kind of guy that just lives by himself, does crazy things like that. And the way the server works is you have to do that personality. So that's what I chose. If I break personality, like, you can actually get banned. So you have to stay in character no matter what when you're playing. They've got all kinds of crazy rules, but basically everything that you do is kind of centered on being like a role player, centered on that character you are. So there are like kingdoms, there are like villages, there are towns where they're safe from raiding. People have like sales, so like maybe once a week on a Saturday there's like a flea market. You can go to that flea market and buy like rare materials, stuff like that. And I think it sounds really fun. So after I finish recording this, I'm basically taking off the rest of the night, play some ARK, play some other games. And we are going to basically try that out, see how it is, because it might be pretty fun to make a series on, like a roleplay thing, like where instead of just like me playing on a server, going for raids, I do a little bit of roleplay and get into character. I think that could be pretty fun. So let me know what you think of that idea. If it sounds something you're interested in, I can definitely do it. Oh my goodness, I was a big dragon. And if not, I might just test it out anyway, just to see how it goes. It sounds interesting. But I'm definitely going to keep this going because it is like so hot, I almost can't even see him right now. That's incredible. Oh, I'm gonna die. What do I do? I don't know what to do. I've never had to deal with this. Yo, I'm about halfway dead. What should I do?
Probably a bad idea coming out here with the heat wave, because it's already hot as fuck out here already.
Got any,
No, you need to get back to the dug, because your fortitude is probably not high enough to be
out here. Oh, I'm going down. I'm about dead right now. It's about to end. I don't think I'm gonna make it.
Well, then just die. Get off the bird, and I'll bring everything back with me.
I'll miss you. It's over, guys. Let's get that fortitude up a little bit. This is the end. Make sure you bury my body. This is it.
I'll go make a gravestone.
This is it. This is how it feels to die. This is how it feels. Oh. Oh, wow. Okay, that was kind of not expected. No, don't kill my baby. Don't kill my baby. Don't kill my baby. Okay, we have quite a few beds. I hope this is the right base. Honestly, I have no idea. I guess it doesn't matter because I have no items anyway. And where are we? Whoa. I don't know if I recognize this particular box, although I can't say for sure. Oh, okay. Oh, a little bed over there. I wasn't aware of that. Well, that's a little bit anticlimactic. We're going to have to try that again and get back out there and raid it. But I'll tell you guys one thing. There was one time in my life where I thought I was going to die when I was in China. Like, I basically got food poisoning. And I remember taking a shower. And my vision started blacking out, just like in this game right now. Started getting dizzy. I couldn't see straight. I was thinking of my girlfriend, my family. But right when I hit this point, I was like, oh my gosh, you're going to pass out and you're going to die right now. This is it, dude. This is the end of your life. And I was naked because I just took a shower. So my last thought before I passed out, it was get pants on so your professor doesn't see you naked. So like I struggled. I put every ounce of effort I had to get those pants on, and I did. And then I passed out on the floor and I woke up in the hospital. But I always thought that my truly last thought would be like, I'm gonna miss you, Lauren. I'm gonna miss you, my family. I'm gonna miss you, my cat. Something profound. Maybe like I would like learn something about myself. But no, I just didn't want to be seen naked by my professor. And I'm just kind of disappointed in myself. You know, I thought maybe I would, maybe I'd be, I don't know. I don't know. When you guys die, like when you're in that final moment, your last thought might not be as profound as you think it is. So remember that when you're dying, like when you're kind of, you know, when your time's come in 50 or 60 years, you're laying there. Maybe your last thought is just like, I hope I don't poop my pants when I die. Maybe it's something like that. That's pretty possible. So I guess we got to wait out the storm. And I'm just going to do a little bit of organizing here and there because that's what I like doing a lot. Just kind of relaxing to put everything in its place, makes it easier down the road. And we're going to go ahead and fly back to the Wyverns here in a second. And we'll see if we can get some Wyvern milk. All right, guys, round two. We're heading back. There's no longer like a super hot sandstorm. And now we're going to figure out how to milk a Wyvern. Oh, and I don't know what's happening. Don't follow me, buddy. I don't know where we're going. All right, ladies and gentlemen, just made it back to the land of the Wyverns. All right, guys, so basically, I guess we're going to attack a female dragon, kite her back, and then kill it. And I'm going to assume that this giant contraption here is how we trap her. I've never done this before, so I really have no idea. Oh, my goodness. Look how big those are. Man, that's, like, really kind of frightening just to see it up above the mountain like that. Oh, my goodness. There are a lot of dragons down here. This seems like a pretty bad idea. Is this really the only way to hatch one? Oh my goodness. Look at that. Oh man. I don't have binoculars or like a telescope, so I can't tell where the females are. But we're just gonna follow this guy. We're gonna see what happens. Ooh, a little poopy there.
Poop it. I got one. Ready?
Alright. I'm ready.
Oh!
Oh my goodness, we're on fire. This is crazy. How do we get out of here? Do we go to our door thing? Is he coming? Oh my gosh, he's coming. He's coming. Okay, well, yeah, I was right. I think we do just bring it right in here. Oh, this is a very unique design. This is very interesting. Come on, buddy. Oh no. I think we gotta get you in the little door trap. Oh my gosh, look at that. It's just right on my tail. Oh baby. Oh baby. This is a little risky. This right here is what I call a very, oh, look at that. Look at that. Oh, get in there. We got him. We got him. We got him. Close it. Go close it.
Good catch, but it's a male. Let him go.
Oh. Well. Alright, that sucks. I was pretty pumped about that one. Is this a female? We're gonna do two? Come on out, buddy. Yep, okay. What do I do? Do I just run away forever? Let him go. Should we kill him? Should I just get out of here? Should I just book it out of here? Oh man, that guy is not happy dragon. I'm gonna like eventually run out of stamina. Maybe, I mean, he's just like coming indefinitely. I don't know how far these things chase, but I'm a little bit concerned right now. Oh, he just left. Look at that. I turned around, I faced him, and he's like, nah, I'm out of here. Okay, we'll go see if my buddy did good work over here and caught that dragon for us. That looks, could be good. He could be in there. I can't really tell. Okay, got one. All right, now what? Let's see. Okay, so how do we kill these bad boys? Do we chainsaw it?
Well, it's a little higher than I like, but I tranq it down because you gotta tranq it to get its milk, and then we just chainsaw it down while it's asleep.
Oh, okay. That's humane. I mean, at least we're not like chainsawing it while it's alive. Oh. Oh no. Got a little guy. Got him. That was a little bit easier than I had expected. What's the point of this windmill over here? It says pin is 1-1.
Might not have enough fucking tranq darts.
Might not have enough tranq darts.
I've just seen female and poison. I didn't. Ooh.
We got this. Maybe. We don't got this, guys. We definitely don't have this. I should have taken. There's a dude laying in our base with darts. Oh, look at him. Is he gonna attack us, or just gonna stand there like a little friendly scorpion? Hello, friendly scorpion. How are you doing today, mister? Huh? How's your little stinger? Oh, no, you're not. Oh. He is friendly. I think someone on base that was passed out had a couple darts I can run back and grab. Oh, perfect. Perfect. Alright, well, I'm not sure. What's the windmill do, guys? What's the windmill do? I haven't looked it up yet. I'm gonna chainsaw this. Oh, baby, look at that. Oh, yeah. Oh, it just gave me a whole lot of stuff. I like the chainsaw. I like the chainsaw a lot. Should I feed my little birdie? Would you care for some meat, my friend? Of course you would. I'll take that right off your back. And I think this is going to give me quite a few levels, too, when we kill it. So, dude's tranking, giant dragon. I'm going to fly up there real quick, get a nice little thumbnail. A little clickbait thumbnail going on here. Is that clickbaity? That's pretty clickbaity, I think. I could do that. Maybe I should get a little closer. A little zoomed in action going on. Get right up in there. Yeah, I like that. We'll call it something super clickbaity, like best dragon ever. Or something. That's good. I took a screenshot earlier, but this is much more clickbaity. Remember, guys, if you're making videos out there, clickbait is all that matters. Even if your content sucks like mine, you just got to get out there. You got to clickbait it. You got to make it real capital letters and everything like that. Even if it's really pretty, like a pretty boring video, capital letters. Got to use the words like insane, most, unbelievable, stuff like that. We'll call this one like unbelievable dragon milking or something. And people be like, whoa, that's pretty cool. I'm going to click on that. So what's this do? Does this close the gate? Why are there fence posts here? I'm just genuinely confused what the windmill's for. Maybe it's just, I don't know. But that's pretty cool. Dude's taking out a dragon. He got it. Nice. So we chainsaw it now? Oh, guys, this is the moment we've been waiting for. Wait, what do we do first? I'm ready to chainsaw this sucker. Is there milk? Like, is there milk in it? Oh, is there milk in it? I think he took it. So is there like milk in it when it passed out? Is that how that works? Mm-hmm. Chainsaw time? Oh, baby. Oh, yeah. Oh, look at this. This is what's up. I'm almost out of chainsaw. No fuel. We're going to pike it. I wish you could just like tame it like normal. But that's okay. We'll just take down its head. Oh my goodness. I feel a little bit bad about this. Yes. Yes. Oh my goodness. Oh, I'm sorry. I think I punched him. All that prime meat, a little bit of sulfur. I think, yeah, that was pretty good. I grew a level or two. Let's get fortitude up. Let's get health up. Let's get weight.
And a level, sweet.
Jeez, ye criminy. All right. Dang, that gave me 30 levels or so. That was nice.
God damn.
That was awesome. Yeah, all right.
Good experience, that's for sure.
That was pretty good. Got a little clickbait in there. Got a little few levels. Got some, I don't know, what else did I get? I got some prime meat. I don't really need all this. Transfer all items. There you go, birdie. It'll last a little bit longer in your belly, won't it? Oh, it's all gone. Oh, he's leaving me. Let's go. Nope, he's turned around. He forgot his chainsaw, maybe. I don't know. Oh, now he's turned around again. Okay, and we're off. Look at this, like, in sync flying. That was pretty cool, guys. Getting that was a lot easier than I thought it would be. But, like, no way I could have done that myself. I noticed when I was watching my girlfriend play this weekend, she basically was, like, playing on my Steam account from her new computer I built. And she was so not afraid of anything. Like, there was, like, a level 5 Carno. She was level 1. And, like, I played for 300 hours, and I see a Carno, I instantly run the other direction. No matter how high of a level I am, I see a Carno, I'm out. She saw a Carno, she ran up to it, she literally clubbed the Carno out and tamed it. And like, I've never even tamed a Carno myself in 300 hours. I am so timid when it comes to this game, because I feel like I've died so many times. That just like, I was like, holy crap, that's insane. And I feel like so many people just don't even care. And I'm like, I care way too much about dying in this game. It's really weird, it's really weird. I guess maybe when I first started playing, I just like died like maybe for like a week straight. I got on, I died, like over and over and over. It just like ingrained in my mind, like you see a Carno, you run the opposite direction. And likewise, you see a dragon, you do not go near it, knock it out, and then steal its body's milk. So just thought that was interesting. Where are we? Oh, hey buddy. Circling around a little bit. And we gotta find some bases around here too. Since we're kind of centralized on this position on the map, should be pretty easy to fly around, look for new bases. Hopefully a big base. Actually, the other day, I was invited to a raid, like to go out with someone, do a crazy raid with him against an alpha on an official server. I was pumped. I wanted to do it so bad, but unfortunately, I was gone for the weekend, couldn't record or anything like that. But I thought that was cool. So if you guys are playing on a server and you want, like, maybe you don't record videos, you think it'll be a great raid. Where are we going? I don't know where we live. Maybe you think it'll be a great raid. Let me know. And I will come to your server, join you, and we can get this raid on camera. So I think that'd be really cool. And we're back. We're back with our milk. Back with our... What do you got in here? Is the milk in this guy? Oh, that's what it looks like. And I think the preserving salt makes it last a little bit longer. This is cool. We're going to have our own wyvern. This is going to be great for raids. Look at him. He's so cute. Little baby dragon. Little tiny guy. So, is he good? Does he need more? How's this work? Where are you going, buddy? Does he eat it instantly? Does he die without it?
You gotta feed him once. It lasts a couple hours.
Oh, okay. That's nice. He heard me something.
In an hour and a half, I'll come back and pet him.
Okay. That's pretty cool. He comes back every hour and a half, gives this guy a little something something. I'm gonna press backspace so we can get a closer look at this guy. Look at those eyes. Those are vicious.
Attempt number two. First one got ate by the dire wolf by accident.
Oh, that's fantastic news. Good to hear.
Okay. Lesson learned. I forgot he was on aggressive.
That is awesome. Look at this little guy. Just kind of hanging out up there. That's pretty cool. I'm not sure why, but I like it. Alright guys, so we are working on taming a dragon. I am working on leveling up because I want to get to the point where I can start crafting some nades, some seafall, and we're going to go find some places to raid here soon because that's why I play this game. I play this game to attack people, to get revenge for what happened to me. My beautiful server. What is this? A little baby poop. A little baby poop? Okay. Alright guys, we are going to go log off right now. Go come into our little log off box, which we kind of have, which is like a little bedroom. And I'm going to check out that roleplay server, see how that is. So let me know if you guys are interested in that, and I'll put a video up of it soon. But for now, that is all I have for today. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys tomorrow back at it with more daily videos. Thanks for watching.